20 children dead, 6 adults, and one of the worst mass shootings in U.S. history has left those in Newtown, in the Sandy Hook section, filled with sadness and questions.
I could not stop shaking.
For what felt like an eternity, Joanne Cantamessa thought her grandkids might have been shot in the Friday morning massacre.
It is a horror. I can't imagine if that was my grandchildren. I'm sorry.
She was relieved to learn her granddaughter and grandson were unharmed. Others weren't so lucky.
It's a very, very sad day in Sandy Hook.
Hairdresser Denise Balog was at work when the stream of ambulances and police rushed by. Like many in town, her shop now shut down for the day.
It's going to be a rough next couple of weeks. I mean, it's right before the holidays as well. It's bad enough to bury your child or anyone.
While the shooting was evil and perhaps the ugliest event one could imagine, conversely, Newtown is picturesque New England, described as Norman Rockwell-esque, normally free of violence.
There was a bit of a magical insulation or a feeling of, you know, tragedy won't happen here. And now it has, and unfortunately, I think it's going to define this town.
But like past shooting tragedies in Colorado, Virginia, and elsewhere, residents realize it's not about where it happened, but those who are now lost. And while shops are closed, with the victims in mind, everyone's hearts remain open.
They keep saying on the TV, oh, Newtown's such a nice town. It doesn't matter, nice town, not a nice town. It could happen anywhere.